Hello, my name is Jacob Monk. Welcome to this short video about NATO and USA. Denmark, we are a member of NATO, and the Danish liberal and conservative politicians, they say it's because NATO, they defends democracy and freedom. Okay. Here in front of me, I have a list of the military campaigns that the leading member of NATO has done since Second World War. I know NATO was started in 1948, so let's see how USA and NATO has worked to defend freedom since 1948. First, we have the Korean War. 1950 to 1953. Well, several million Koreans were killed. USA was the leading actor in this campaign, but other NATO countries, including Denmark, supported NATO, supported USA, not by weapons, but with military aid. So this was some kind of NATO operation. And the result was the division of Korea. North Korea is some kind of dictatorship, socialist dictatorship. South Korea is a capitalist dictatorship. So I don't think that human rights and freedom has conquered, has had succeed in Korea since the Korean War. And the reason for the Korean War was the invention of USA, the military campaign and bombardment that USA did against North Vietnam. In 1950 to 1953, USA participated in a bombing campaign against China. The reason, I don't know, but I have the list here of all the American bombing campaigns since the Second World War. Third, Guatemala. America invaded and bombed Guatemala 1954. They invaded and bombed Indonesia in 1958. They invaded and bombed Cuba in 1959 to 1960. They invaded and bombed Guatemala in 1960. Belgian Congo, 1964, Guatemala again, 1964, Dominican Republic, 1966, Peru, 1965, Laos, 1973, Vietnam, 1961 until 73, the so-called Vietnam War. The war against Cambodia was from 1969 to 1970. The Lebanon war was from 1982 to 1984. Bombardment of Grenada 1983 to 1984. Bombardment of Libya, I'm not talking about the last Libya war, the first Libya war, 1986. El Salvador 1992, from 81 until 92. Nicaragua, 1981 till 90. Iran, 1987 until 88. Libya, 1989. Panama, 1990. Iraq, 1991. Kuwait, 1991. Somalia, 1992 until 94, Bosnia, 1995, Iran, 1998, Sudan, 1998, Afghanistan, 1998, Yugoslavia and Serbia, 1999, Afghanistan, 2001, and Libya, 2011. Well, nowadays, USA is in Syria too. So maybe we should mention Syria too. But This is the military actions that the leading member of NATO, USA, has made against small, defenseless nations around the world. The reason has always been to force upon them the American view of the world, the American Hollywood culture, and to make them a part of the American empire, and the empire run by Hollywood and run by the dollar printed and made in USA. And the only reason that USA has been able to keep up all these wars is because that USA is having the global currency called dollar as their own currency. This is the only country where they are able to print dollar, to make dollar without having any production, because the real production in USA is very small. But they have debt, very much debt, so much they will never be able to pay it back to foreign countries. The only reason that America can run the world, make terrorist actions all across the world using their big military and their 800 military bases around the world, the only reason is that they control the dollar. The world is not fair, no, but I hope it will change in the future. But first of all, we have to tell the lies, to expose the lies and make the truth recognized again instead of the lies. And the first lie is that USA is defending freedom. NATO is a tool for freedom and democracy. Well, if you read this list here or listened, you will understand that only in very few of these countries they have a real democracy. And in USA, I'm sorry to say it, this is not a real democracy either. It is run by the deep state. The deep state. The deep state, it is the organizations, the capitalists owning the medias and thereby controlling the voters and the electoral process going on before they elect a new president. At the moment, it's Donald Trump who is the American president. I hope it will change, but I'm afraid it won't make a lot of difference. America is a war nation, and war is the opposite of peace, freedom, and democracy. That's why I made this list, and I hope you will understand that being a supporter of NATO is the same as being a supporter of death, bombardment, dictatorship, and modern colonialism with USA in the center. Thank you for listening.